Hello folks, and welcome to GED Microlearning. My name is Dr. MCR, and in this episode, we're going to go over five questions of the GED math test. The first question requires you interpret data from a table. So here, they're giving you the scores obtained by GED candidates in 2 years, 2012 and 2020, and what they're asking is which category of students showed the least improvement from 2012 to 2020. So let's quickly look at the table. So if you look on the far left, it's telling you the bracket of scores. So there's students who scored between 100 to 144. There's students who passed, meaning that they scored over 145. Then we have a bracket of students who were college ready. They scored 165 to 174. And finally, we have those students who were college ready plus credit. Okay, so they scored over 175. And then if you look at the other two columns, these correspond to the years. So that's 2012. And you can see what percentage of students scored in each bracket. And that's 2020. Okay, so how do you solve this problem? Well, the first thing, let's look at the first category of students. To find out the percentage improvement, what you would do is you would use this formula, amount of change divided by the original value times 100. So in this case, we have in 2020, there were 19 students in this category, 19%. Minus the original amount, which was 17%, divided by 17, and you multiply that by 100. That would give you ultimately 11.76% difference. If we look at the second category, we do the same thing. Okay, so the amount of change would be 76 minus 73, the original value, divided by 73 and multiply that by 100. So here our result would be 17.64%. And then we go for the third category. So these are the college ready folks. So again, how much change did we have from 2012 to 2020? We would say 64 minus 56 divided by 56 times 100. And that gives you a change of 14.28%. And finally, in the college-ready students plus credit, the amount of change would be 37 minus 31 divided by 31, which was the original value, times 100. And the percent change would be 19.35%. Okay, so if we put all of those values in this table now, and we look at the question again, and it says which category showed the least improvement from 2012 to 2020, you can see that it's the first category, okay, because the percentage change was only 11.76 compared to other categories where there was a higher percentage change. Okay, so question number two requires you to find a percentage. So they tell us that Joe paid a 20% tip on a $45 haircut. So how much was the tip? So to do this, you would multiply $45 times 20%, which is expressed like this in a fraction, 20 divided by 100, and that would give you 9. You could also do it with a decimal, right? So 20% is the same as saying 0.2. Okay, that gives you also 9, so it's the same answer. Okay, so question number 3 requires that you understand the decimal system. And here they're asking which of the following correctly shows 7.5183 rounded to the nearest hundredth. So what you have to remember here is if you look at the decimal system, when you have a decimal point, everything to the right would be tenths, followed by hundredths, thousands, and ten thousands. And then everything to the left would be ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, etc. So here, they're asking you the nearest hundredths. So if you look at your number, that would be that number, okay? So you want to round to the nearest hundredths, which would be that number. So in this case, if you look to the right, there's a number 8, which means that we're going to round up, and the correct answer would be 7.52, okay, because we're rounding that 51 up to 2. Okay, so question four is a question that requires you to do a little bit of work with fractions. Here, they're telling you that they're preparing a salad dressing, which requires 2 cups and 1/3 cups of olive oil, 1/2 cup of lemon juice, and 3/4 cup of yogurt. How many cups of salad dressing will this recipe produce? And they're giving you 4 options of how much you produce. So step number one would be to change your mixed numbers to improper fractions. So in the problem, they said that you have 2 1/3 cups of olive oil. So what you want to do is you want to change that to an improper fraction. And just quickly to remind yourself how to do that, the way that you do it is that you would multiply that 2 by the denominator. Okay, that would give you 6. And then you would add the numerator, the 1. Okay, so 2 times 3 is 6, plus 1 is 7. And then the denominator remains 3. Okay, so now we can take all of our fractions, right? So we have 7/3 for the olive oil, 1/2 cup for the lemon juice, and 3/4 for the yogurt. And remember that the rule is that when you are adding fractions, they all have to have a common denominator, okay? It has to be the same number on the bottom. So that's the first thing that you have to do, find the common denominator. In this case, the common denominator would be 12. So what do you do now? So you look at the first fraction, 7/3, and you think, how do you get the denominator up to 12? Well, multiplying by 4. So you would multiply the 3 by 4, and then the top number, the numerator, would also be multiplied by 4. Then you look at the second fraction, 1/2. And again, we said that the common denominator is going to be 12. So you would have to multiply that 2 by 6, and you also multiply the top number, your numerator, by 6. And then finally, the 3/4, how do you get the common denominator to be 12? Well, by multiplying by 3. Once you've done all that, this is what comes out. So you end up with the common denominator, which is 12. And then to add fractions, remember that you just add the numerators, the top numbers, together. And the denominator, the bottom number, remains the same. So if you add that, 28 plus 6 plus 9 gives you 43 over 12. So if we now change that fraction to a mixed number, that would give us 3 7/12 of a cup. So your correct answer would be D. All right, and the final question has to do with exponents. So as you know, part of the GED test, you are allowed a calculator, but for some questions, you are not allowed a calculator. And this question requires you to do the problem without a calculator. So if they ask you to solve this expression, so 5 raised to the 3rd power, how would you do that? First of all, let's remind ourselves, if you have that exponent, what does that mean? Well, that number, that exponent, what it's telling you is how many times you have to multiply the big number, the whole number, by itself. Okay, so here they're telling you 5 to the power of 3. What that means is that 5 has to be multiplied by itself 3 times. So 5 times 5 times 5. So 5 times 5 is 25. Times 5 would be 125. So your answer would be D. Okay, folks, hope you found that helpful. If you did and you want more videos like this, make sure to subscribe to the channel. And as always, folks, stay positive and stay strong. I'm rooting for you. Have a great day, and thank you so much for your time. Thanks for watching.